sir, you can start.
Good evening, everyone present here today on this virtual session. This is the first webinar series organized by the Vivekananda College of Law and the Janata Education Society and the alumni of Vivekananda College of Law. Today, the topic for the day is plant variety and farmers' rights and the law relating to the same. Amidst us today, we have a resource person, Mr. Kiran, a good friend of mine, and an alumni of Vivekananda College of Law, and a very popular lawyer and a very good speaker. I welcome Mr. Kiran for this webinar. So before we begin today's session, I request our beloved principal of Vivekananda College of Law to introduce the gathering as well as today's speaker. Over to you, sir, please.
Good evening. Janata Education Society's Vivekananda College of Law, as an IQAC initiative, in association with our alumni friends, has organized this first series of webinar, in which today we have amidst us Shri Kiran CV, an alumnus of our institution. And it's my privilege to give you his brief introduction. After obtaining his law degree in the year 2008, Mr. Kiran enrolled as an advocate. But even after his enrollment, he continued his studies and obtained his post-graduation diploma in IPR from NLSIU, participated in a certificate course on alternative dispute resolution organized by South Asian Institute of Advanced Legal and Human Rights Studies, SAILS, in collaboration with Brack University from May 29 to June 29, 2010 at Dhaka, Bangladesh. His professional and academic achievements are more, but I try to give his brief introduction. He has participated and delivered lectures on various topics in many national and international workshops and symposiums, worked as a research assistant in NLSIU Bangalore in the project Impact of Offshoring of Clinical Trials to India in collaboration with Ministry of Health and Family Welfare Union of India. He prepared questionnaire to various stakeholders and conducted interviews with stakeholders, analyzed their responses and drafted the report, and the same is published by the WHO. He worked as a researcher in NLSIU, again in the project IPR and biotechnology. The objective of the project was to bring out a manual on the best IPR practices for biotech industry. Wrote fifth units for the Master of Intellectual Property Law launched by IGNO School of Law in collaboration with Queensland University of Technology, Australia, for Course 7 Advanced IP Issues. He worked as part-time lecturer in our own institution till recently. His experiences as an advocate, he is practicing particularly on IPR side and clinical research consultant in Bangalore. See, he is practicing civil side, IPR, labor and industrial laws, corporate laws, conveyance and property matters, and represent various matters before the courts and tribunals. He is a legal consultant and a constituted attorney for Metro Rail Corporation Limited, that is NAMMA Metro, and was advising and prosecuting the IPR trademark related issues. He is the legal consultant on IPR issues for National Translation Mission, a spin-off of the National Knowledge Commission at Central Institute of Languages. He is the panel advocate for Mysore Sugar Company Limited, panel advocate and consultant to Bangalore Development Authority. He is a very active member in Rotary, he is a Rotarian, and then he has contributed and devoted his time for social work. And at present, he has his office in Bangalore, Mrs. Rexlex Incorporation, and then he is doing well, as Raghavendra rightly mentioned. He is a busy practitioner, and Kiran, we are really happy for accepting our invitation in a short notice, and you have prepared yourself to deliver lecture on this very important topic. And I, on behalf of Janata Education Society, Sri Vivekananda College of Law, and our Alumni Association, a warm welcome is reserved to you, Kiran.
Thank you for your kind words.
Welcome. And I, on behalf of our Alumni Association, welcome the office bearers of Janata Education Society, members, Managing Committee of Janata Education Society, and our GC members, and also office bearers and all other members of our Alumni Association. Many academics have joined today. Probably Mr. Raghavendra will mention it at the end to acknowledge their presence. And all the academics, students from other institutions, and our own institution have joined here. I welcome each one of you, including my colleague friends. Thank you one and all.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you for your formal gesture. The only source of food is oxygen and plant across the globe. Applying IPR regime to plant is one of the greatest initiative. Now we have so many laws and so many voices across the India as far as the farmers' rights and their trade is concerned, and their participation in the trade is concerned. Under these circumstances, today's very relevant topic is on plants and farmers' rights. So I call upon our resource person, Mr. Kiran, to take over the session. Please, Mr. Kiran, session is yours.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for your kind words. So both of them are my teachers. Whatever knowledge I gain from them. So I try my best, what best I can give out from their experience and also from their teachings. Thank you for the kind gesture, sir. When it comes to the farmer rights and plant protection and varieties, before I start, just I have a question to all. Are we all educated?
Qualified.
Qualified, okay.
Almost educated.
Almost educated.
So the education, I cannot define the word education.
Still in the process of education.
Because before I start this session, I just asked this question because I want to share a very small story of my own. My grandfather used to soak the paddy in the salt water for a few minutes. Then he used to remove whichever goes down, keep it in another bag, and whichever comes up, he used to keep it in another. And he used to dry it and used to get it rice converted into rice, whichever is on the upper layer of the water. Whichever goes, that was used as a seed. So when I was doing my research in Mysore, especially with the CIL, one of the professor I was interacting with them, and I was sharing this story. Earlier, I was thinking that, okay, he's doing that, so while cooking the rice, we need not add the salt. That was the impression I got by seeing it engage. Then he said, that's the traditional method to find out the best grains for sowing the seeds, especially for the paddy. Then he said, sir, I have done so much of research, I never know this. Then he said, you are illiterate. But he was educated. You know the way of life, what is required. Because anything, everything can be manufactured in a industry, but not the food. This is the prime thing that nobody ever understood. Because if you have to balance, then you have to learn, live with the nature. This is what the message, what my grandparents has given to me. So now coming to the presentation. Protection of plant varieties and farmer rights. Is the screen is shared?
Yes, yes, Kiran.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
See, history of evolution of the sector in India, though agriculture is the backbone of India from the time immemorial, I can say, because we were cultivating and our ancestors, whoever are cultivating the crops or any fruits or anything. But industrialization has thought on only in the early 19th century. Because of the Bengal famine in the year 1943, there was an acute shortage of especially the rice and wheat varieties in India. So 47 to 67, the efforts were largely concentrated on expanding the farming. But however, these kind of expansions were got into the real mode or in real strike only in the year 1967 when the Green Revolution started. The 1967 Green Revolution consists of major three factors, namely continued expansion of farming areas, that is enlarged work field. The second more important is double cropping or existing farmland. Normally, most of the time, I think if there are any farmers or farmer background, they know the paddy is grown only in the rainy season, not in the summer season. But many of the indigenous farmers used to grow rye in the summer season and paddy in the rainy season. That is double cropping existing farmland. And also because of the advent of the then government and farming of various dams, the water resources were made available for the double cropping throughout the year. Third important, using seeds with improved genetics. This is where the first focus after the then imperial government started in 1905, they established Department of Revenue, Agriculture and Commerce together with a bacteriological laboratory in British Rule. In the pre-independence era, the Indian Agriculture Research Institute was started in 1936. Post-independence, it was shifted to New Delhi. And this led to six agricultural colleges and instrumental in the Green Revolution in 1960s. In 1929 also, the Indian Council for Agriculture Research was established and it was remodeled or reorganized in the year 1965 and 1973. Before going to the next step, here I just wanted to share a few things. Using seeds with improved genetics, this is where the bedrock lies for the formation or the act which now we are going to discuss, that is the Plant Protection and Farmer Rights Act. When we said the Green Revolution and using the seeds with improved genetics, this led to a lot of commotion between the farmers and also the companies. I think many of you might remember Professor Nanjundia for this. When early 80s, when the Monsanto introduced the cotton seeds, there was a huge cry. What is the reason behind this? If you look at the genetics, when the commercially established organization or industries enter into this field, by the way of genetics, they remove the regenerating characters of that particular seed. So it can grow only once, but it cannot reproduce. This is something which was affecting the farmers. ಇವತ್ತು ನಾವೆಲ್ಲ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ ಸಾವಯವ ಕೃಷಿ ಅಂತ, ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಕ್ ಫಾರ್ಮಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಎಗೈನ್ ಅವರ್ ಇಂಡಿಜಿನಿಯಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಟ್ರೆಡಿಷನಲ್ ನಾಲೆಡ್ಜ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಬೆಟರ್ ಸೈಂಟಿಫಿಕ್ ವೇ ವಿರ್ ಇಂಪ್ರೂವಿಂಗ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅಪ್ಲೈಯಿಂಗ್ ನೌ. ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ವೆನ್ ದ ಕಮರ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರೀಸ್ ಎಂಟರ್ ದ ಸೀಡ್ ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟ್, ದ ಸೀಡ್ ಆಕ್ಟ್ ಕೇಮ್ ಇನ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್, ದೇ ಎನ್ಶೂರ್ ದಟ್ ದ ಯೂಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೀಡ್ಸ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ ಎ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಪೆಸ್ಟಿಸೈಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸರ್ಸ್, which led the land into barren. And that's how the farmers' right started cropping up across the world. It took almost from 1970s to 2000, almost three decades for the government to realize the plant variety protection and also farmer rights to be ascertained. Some of the historical milestones in the evolution of the sector, I will not go through the entire thing. I can just go through the slides or later. So if you see, the Indian Patent Act came in 1970 and the seed rules came in 1969 and the Seed Act came in 1965. But only in the year 2001, the Production of Plant Varieties and Farmers Act came. So almost 65 to 2000, it is almost 35 years. It took that the governments to realize that protection of farmers' right and plant varieties is very much important. At this hour, I just wanted to share one small story of a poor farmer. ಡಿಆರ್ ಕೆಂದಾಗ ಇದ್ಯಾರಪ್ಪ ಎಷ್ಟು ಡಿ ಆಡ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಂತ ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡಬಹುದು. ದಾದಾಜಿ ರಾಮ್ಜಿ ಕೋಪರೇಟ್ ಗೇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಪೂರ್ ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಹಾರಾಷ್ಟ್ರ, ಚಂದಾಪುರ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಟ್ ಮಹಾರಾಷ್ಟ್ರ. ಈ ಹಸ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟೆಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಸರ್ಟನ್ ವೆರೈಟೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ರೈಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಬಾಸುಮತಿ. ಇಸ್ ಇನೋವೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಈ ಹಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ದಿಸ್ ರೈಟ್ ಟು ದ ಅಗ್ರಿಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಿಟಿ ಇನ್ ದ ವೇ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಇನ್ 1980s ಅಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಬಿಕೇಮ್ ಮೋರ್ ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ರೈಸ್ ವಾಸ್ ಸೋಲ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಅಗ್ರಿಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಿಟಿ ವಿದೌಟ್ ಗಿವಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಎನಿ ಬೆನಿಫಿಟ್ to this man. Only in the year 2005 the National Innovation Foundation recognizes entrepreneurship, and also the Fortune magazine published the story of him. Then the government, all the government and everybody realized his contribution, and two varieties of his own, that is HMT and DRK, has been recognized and given the protection under Plant Variety Protection Act. And he just sold both of that right for just mere 1 lakh to the same foundation in the year 2003-04 after the registration. Though he was one of the greatest man in breeding this technology or scientifically advanced technology, where per acre a paddy can be yielded 20 to 25 acres, but from this his seeds it has grown up to 40 to 45 bags. That was his innovation and his breeding abilities, which benefited many farmers around in Maharashtra. That's one of the a small example. If I take one more example, Professor Mahadevappa. ಸರಿ ಗೊತ್ತಿರುತ್ತೆ ಪ್ರಿನ್ಸಿಪಲ್ ಸರ್ಗೆ, ಪ್ರೊಫೆಸರ್ ಮಹಾದೇವಪ್ಪ, ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ ವೈಸ್ ಚಾನ್ಸಲರ್ ಆಫ್ ಧಾರವಾಡ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಿಟಿ. ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಎಸ್ ರೈಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾನ್. ಹೌ ಮೆನಿ ಆಫ್ ಯು ಅವೇರ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಟ್? ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಆನಂದು, ಅವತಿ, ಕಾವೇರಿ ಅಂತೆಲ್ಲ ಇಂಟ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಯ್ತಲ್ಲ ತಳಿಗಳು, ಪ್ಯಾಡಿ, ದೋಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ ಬೈ ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ರೊಫೆಸರ್ ಮಹಾದೇವಪ್ಪ ವೆನ್ ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ಎ ಅಗ್ರಿಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಸೈಂಟಿಸ್ಟ್. ಇನ್ late early 70s he introduced, and it has given to 11 countries he has exchanged his knowledge, and more particularly for 2.5 years he was in Philippines working for the growth of high yielding rice, and he was awarded internationally from 1980s to 2000. Of late in 1999 Indian government recognized him and given the Padma Shri, and 2014 he was awarded Padma Bhushan Professor Mahadevappa, who is also known as Rice Man. So these are all the genuine minds who work for the upliftment of the farmer community. So taking away this, the government of India has started National Pulse Development Program covering 13 states for launched in 1986. Technology Mission on Oil Seeds was launched in 1986. And Ministry of Food and Processing Industry was established in the ministry in July 1988. Now coming to the exact plant protection of varieties and farmer right act 2001, which was enacted to grant intellectual property rights to the plant variety breeders, researchers and farmers who have developed any new or extant plant varieties. See here, the essential derived varieties can also be registered under this act I will come at the later stage, what is the text? Essential derived varieties. Farmers, by this act, it has given the power to the farmers to save, use, sow, resow, exchange or sell their farm products, including seed, of a registered variety in an unbranded manner. Farmers' varieties are eligible for registration. Under this act, the farmers can claim for compensation if the registered variety fails to provide performance under given condition, expected performance. The act gives the power for the farmers to claim compensation. The rights granted under this act are exclusive rights. He has the right to produce, sell, market, distribute, import, and export the variety. Civil and criminal remedies are provided for enforcement of breeders' rights and provision related to breeder sharing and compulsory license in case of registered varieties not made available to the public at reasonable price are provided. Compensation is also provided for village or community if any registered variety has been developed using any variety in violation of the such registered varieties. What are the objective of the PPV and FR Act? The first is to establish an effective system for production of plant variety, the rights of the farmers and plant breeders are to encourage the development of new plant varieties and plants, to recognize and protect the rights of the farmers in respect of their contribution made at any time in conserving, improving and making available plant genetic resources, to accelerate agricultural development in the country, protect plant breeders' rights, stimulate investment for research and development both in public and private sector, facilitate the growth of seed industry in the country, which will ensure the availability of high quality seeds and planting material to the farmers. Section 2C defines breeder, a person or a group of persons or a farmer or a group of farmers or any institution which has bred, evolved or developed any variety. And Section 2K deals with farmers, means any person who cultivate crops by cultivating land himself or cultivate crops by directly supervising cultivation or land through any other person or conserves and preserves severally or jointly with any other person any wild species or traditional varieties, or adds value to such wild species or traditional varieties through selection and identification of their useful resource. When we say traditional varieties, recently I have come across one of the farmer from Pandavapura. He grows a kind of sugar cane and he makes jaggery out of that. He never sells to factories or any other. So I just met him for some other reasons and asked him why you are not protecting under plant varieties. I was taken aback for the knowledge of the act, what he has. Literally, I came back and checked that and realized what he's saying is right. He said, DM Swami, you put up 15 years of protection. No. ನಾನು 15 ವರ್ಷದಿಂದ ಆಗಲೇ ಬೆಳೀತಾನೆ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ. ಡಿ ಆರ್ ಕೆ ಕತೆ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದು ಅವರೇ, ನನ್ನ ಹಂಗೆ ಮಾಡ್ಬಿಡ್ತಾರೆ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಜನ. ನನ್ನ ವೆರೈಟಿ ನಾನು ಯಾರಿಗೂ ಸೀಟ್ ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ, ನಾನೇ ಕಬ್ಬು ಬೆಳಿತೀನಿ, ನಾನೇ ಬೆಲ್ಲ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ಜಾಗರ್ ಇಸ್ ಸೋ ಫೇಮಸ್ ದಟ್ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಆಯುರ್ವೇದ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಆರ್ ಮ್ಯಾನುಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಚರರ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರೊಕ್ಯೂರ್ ದ ಜಾಗರಿ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಹಿಮ್ ಅಟ್ ಎ ವೆರಿ ಹೈ ರೇಟ್. I just wanted to test how can it can be a different. So I requested to give me a packet of jaggery. I came home and I informed, instead of sugar, use this jaggery. Let me see. So after that, I just forget about that. And one fine day, my wife asked me, are you not finding any difference in your coffee? I said, no. It tastes the same what you were doing earlier. But now I am adding the jaggery, not sugar. Normally, there will be a change in the taste when you add jaggery to coffee rather than sugar. I think most of you might have experienced this. So that's what the plant breeders and variety, they in their own way, they have secured their traditional knowledge. The act came into existence in compliance of Article 27.3 of TRIPS Agreement in a sui generis form. There are four types of varieties, that is, which are protected under this act. One is new variety. A variety is a plant grouping except microorganisms within a single botanical taxon of the lowest known rank, which can be defined by the expression of the characteristics resulting from a genotype of that plant grouping, distinguished from any other plant grouping by expression of at least one characteristic and considered as a unit with regard to its suitability for being propagated, which remains unchanged after such propagation and includes propagating materials such as of such variety extent, transgenic variety, farmer's variety, and essentially derived variety. The extant variety, the second one is the extant variety, is a variety available in India which is notified under Section 5 of the Seed Act or farmer's variety, a variety about which there is common knowledge or any other variety which is in public domain. Essentially derived variety, essentially derived is the variety that is identical to the parent variety except a single character change. The essentially derived variety can be derived directly from a parent variety or can come from a variety that was predominantly derived from a parent variety. The EDV, what we called as, must keep the essential characteristics that result from the initial variety genotype, but at the same time must be clearly distinguishable from the initial variety. The fourth one is the farmer's variety. Farmer's variety relates to a variety which has been traditionally cultivated and evolved by the farmers in their field, or is a wild relative or land race of a variety about which the farmers possess the common language knowledge. So if you look at one of the farmer's variety which was qualified for geographical indication, especially in Chikbalapura region, there are many farmers who grow black grapes. That is a specific variety where an application has been filed for granting of geographical indication because the wine manufactured from that grapes tasted different from the grapes which have been cultivated otherwise. What are the requirements for a new variety to conform to the criteria of registration? The first is novelty. If the propagating or harvested material has not been sold or otherwise disposed of by or with consent of its breeder or is unsuccessful for exporting of the variety, if it is in India earlier than 1 year, it has to be registered. If it is in outside India, the variety has to be registered here. It has to be at least in existence for 6 years. In any other cases, for the trees and wife, it is only 4 years from the date of filing of such application, such variety has to be evolved. Distinctiveness, the second important character to register a variety is if the variety is clearly distinguishable by at least one essential characteristic from any other variety whose existence is a matter of common knowledge in any country at the time of filing of the application. Uniformity, if subject to the variation that may be expected from the particular features of its propagation, it is sufficiently uniform in the essential characteristics. And stability, this is more important. It is the essential characteristic remain unchanged after repeat propagation or in the case of particular cycle of propagation at the end of each cycle, that means the harvesting cycle, what we say. It should not change the stability after year after year changing the sowing or reproducing. To implement this provision, the Government of India established Department of Agriculture Cooperation, Farmers Welfare, Minister of Agriculture and Farmers established the Production of Plant Variety and Farmer Rights Authority on 11th November 2005. It consists of chairperson, who is the executive, chief executive of the authority. Besides the chairperson, the authority has 15 members as notified by the Government of India. 8 of them are ex-officio members representing various departments, ministers, 3 from state agricultural universities and the state government, 1 representative each from farmers, tribal organization, seed industry, and women organization associated with agricultural activities are nominated by the central government. And the Registrar General is the ex-official member, secretary of the authority. The genetic resource of agrovet plants and their wild relatives, particularly in areas identified as agro-biodiversity hotspots, are awarded annually. From Gene Fund, the name of the award is Plant Genome Survivor Community Award, and the amount is INR 10 lakh for each community. A maximum of 5 awards are conferred in a year. The Production of Plant Varieties and Farmer Rights Authority has also confirms Plant Genome Savior, Farmer Reward, Farmer Recognition to the farmers engaged in the conduction of genetic resources of land, races, and wild relatives of economic plants, and their improvement through selection and preservation, and the material so selected and preserved has been used as the donors of gene in varieties registrable under the PPV and FR Act. Up to 10 rewards and 20 recognition, which include a citation, moment, and cash, are conferred every year. The general functions of the authority are registration of new plant varieties or essentially derivatives and extinct varieties, developing DUS test fields, guidelines for new species, that is distinctiveness, uniformity, and stability, developing characterization and documentation of varieties registered, compulsory cataloging facilities for all variety of plants, documentation, indexing, and cataloging of farmer varieties, recognition and rewarding farmers, community of farmers, particularly tribal and rural community, engaging conservation and improvement. Preservation of plant genetic resource of economic plants and their wild relatives, maintenance of the National Register of Plant Varieties, and maintenance of National Gene Bank. What are the rights confirmed under the Act? The first is the breeder's right. The breeders will have exclusive rights to produce, sell, market, distribute, import, or export the protected variety. Breeder can appoint agent, license, and may exercise for civil remedy in case of infringement of rights. And a researcher right, researcher can use any of the registered variety under the Act for conducting experimental research. This includes the use of variety as an initial source of variety for the purpose of developing another variety, but repeated use needs prior permission of the registered breeder. The farmer's right, the farmer who has evolved or developed a new variety is entitled for registration and production in like manner as a breeder of a variety. Farmer variety can also be registered as an extinct variety. A farmer can save, use, sow, resow, exchange, share, or sell his farm products, including seed of a variety protected under the Act, in the same manner he was entitled before the Act coming into force. And he is entitled to sell branded seed of a variety protected under the Act, but if it is registered under him. Farmers are eligible for recognition and rewards for the conservation of plant genetic resources of land, races, and wild relative of economic plants. There is also a compensation provision under Section 39, Class 2 of the Act, where the protected variety did not give a yield as expected from the gene fund, which is being with the authority, and plant varieties and other seeds. A variety is eligible for registration under that if it is essentially fulfilled the criteria, as we commonly called as DUS. The central government issues notification in an official gadget specifying the genera and species for the purpose of registering, and the same is available with the authority, that is plantauthority.gov.in. The Act also developed guidelines for the conduct of species specific distinctiveness, uniformity and stability tests, are specific guidelines for individual crop species. The time limit for registration of exempt variety is available on the official website of the authority. What is the fee applicable to get it registered? For any extinct variety notification under Section 5 of the Seed Act, that is with regarding to the seeds, is ₹2,000. That is any private party or public person who wanted to register under him, if he is not a farmer. And if any new variety, essential derived variety or extinct variety, which where there is a common knowledge, variety with certain knowledge is also treated as distinct variety. For that, if it is an individual, ₹7,000. If it is an educational institution like agricultural universities, it is ₹10,000. If it is a commercial entity, it is ₹50,000. But for farmer varieties, there is no fees prescribed under the Act, and the same has been published in the official gadget of 15/6/2015 of Union of India. What is this DUS? The authority has notified DUS test center for different crops with a mandate for maintaining and multiplication of reference collection, example varieties, and generation of database for DUS description as per DUS guidelines of respective crop. The list of DUS test centers is available with the authority on their website. Where you get the details of this plant variety is the journal which is published by the authority, that is Plant Variety Journal of India. Authority publishes its official journal, that is Plant Variety Journal of India, as a monthly bilingual Hindi and English publication, and it is equivalent to the gadget notifications as published by the governments. Where in the journal, the publication includes the passport data, public notices or any official notices issued to anybody, DUS test guidelines, crop species, and details of certificate of registration, other related matters. What is the certificate? Once the certificate of registration, what it contains, application which have fulfilled all the requirements have been finally accepted by the registrar for registration, And totally, till today, there are 3,441 certificates have been issued, out of which 477 have been issued for the new varieties, 1,431 for extant varieties notified under the Seed Act, 1,532 for farmer varieties, and only one essential derived variety has been granted. The certificate of registration issued will be valid for 9 years in case of trees and vines and 6 years in case of other crops. I told a story of a farmer from Pandupura who make a special kind of jaggery. This information I was not aware. And he said, it may be renewed and renewed for the remaining period and payment of renewal fee subject to the condition that total period of validity shall not exceed 18 years in case of trees and vines. And for other varieties, it is 15 years from the date of notification of variety under the Seed Act. And till now, till July 2018, the authority has received 16,382 applications on various categories for registration, including farmers. These are some of the graphs which depict, like EDV new farmer, extent of the varieties, common knowledge, extent notified. And these are the year-wise certificate issued by the authority. So it was at its peak in 2014-15. 2021 and 2021-22, probably for the pandemic, it has been at a decline rate. The National Register of Plant Varieties contains the has been kept at the head office of the registry, containing the names of all the registered plant varieties with the names and addresses of their respective breeders, the right of such breeders in respect of the registered varieties, the particulars of the denomination of each registry variety, its seed or other propagating material, along with the specification of salient features thereof, such other matters as may be prescribed. Now comes National Gene Bank. I just wanted to share a small story. Many agriculture universities are producing many seeds, that is the variant seeds, which has been mutated. Similarly, under every state government, there are many, every state government, there are many departments like agriculture department, horticulture, and these departments are to use the fields which are allocated to them to do this experiment. Also, we call it as DUS test centers, but not all the state government's centers have been used for DUS. Some of them. I remember way back in 2005-06, why, when Monsanto came into picture, the commercial organization, it took almost 70% of the market in competition with the government seeds manufacturing units. As we are doing some research in 2005-06 on the Seed Act and other related issues for the journal and the book to be published. So I went to the ministry and got a list of the seed manufacturing places in Karnataka. And I found very interesting, one is in my hometown where I studied. I was born and brought up and studied my initial education. So then I called one of my friends and said, ಈ ಜಾಗ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಬರುತ್ತೋ ಅಂತ ಏನಕ್ಕೂ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳ್ದ ಕೇಳ್ದ ಏ ಅದೇ ಕಣ ಮೋತಿ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ಅಂತ ನಾವು ಕರೆಯಲ್ಲ ಕ್ರಿಕೆಟ್ ಆಡ್ತೀವಲ್ಲ ಅದು ಅಂತ ಏ ಮತ್ತೆ ಡಾಟಾ ನೋಡಿದ್ರೆ ಪ್ರತಿ ವರ್ಷ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಸೀಡ್ ಬೆಳೆದ ಜನರು ಗಂಜಿದ್ದವ್ರೆ ಅಂತ ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಸಿ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ಐ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಯೂಸ್ ದ ವರ್ಡ್ ವೆದರ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಎಜುಕೇಟೆಡ್ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಟೈಮ್ ದ ಬ್ಯೂರೋಕ್ರಾಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಥೌಟ್ ನೋಯಿಂಗ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮಿಂಗ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಹೌ ದೇ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ take of statistics, they create something and say, okay, this has been generated, but it is not used. So let's procure from the, as the yield is very low, procure from the private storage. So that in order to come out of these situations, this National Gene Bank is of much help, because here in the National Seed Bank, the varieties, that is the seeds, are stored at minus 50 degrees Celsius for the entire registration period. And if necessary, after a few years of storage in the National Gene Bank, the seed lot will be rejuvenated and replaced at the cost of applicant. The seed stored in the National Gene Bank will be used for dispute settlement or when an exigency arises for invoking compulsory license provisions. Such a seed deposition in the National Gene Bank would discern market malpractices or violations, as the sample in custody can be drawn to verify the facts. When the period of registration granted lapses, the material automatically moves to public domain. So this can create more gene and the seeds available for the public at large. The National Gene Fund, a National Gene Fund has been established by the authority to receive the contribution from the benefit sharing received in the prescribed manner for the breeder of a variety or an essential derived variety registered under the Act, or the propagating material of such variety or essential derived variety as the case may be. The annual fee payable to the authority by way of royalty, the compensation deposited by breeders, and the contribution from any national or international organization for development of these traditional varieties. But there are strict rules how the gene fund shall be utilized. That is, any amount to be paid by way of benefit sharing, that is to the community which goes, the compensation payable to the farmer or community of farmers, the expenditure for supporting the conservation and suitable use of genetic resources, including in situ and ex situ collections, and for strengthening the capability of the panchayat in carrying out such conservation and sustainable use. The expenditure of the schemes related to benefit sharing. What is benefit sharing? The benefit sharing is one of the most important ingredients of the farmer's rights. Section 26 provides benefit sharing, and the claim can be submitted by the citizens of India or firms or non-governmental organizations formed or established in India, depending upon the extent and nature of the use of genetic material of the claimant in the development of the variety, along with the commercial utility and demand in the market for the variety breeder. This benefit sharing will be shared either to the community or the farmer who involved in deriving this variety. The authority also publishes the contents of the certificate in PVJF journal, that is Blank Variety Journal of India, for the purpose of inviting claims for benefit sharing. What are the rights of the community under this Act? It is a compensation to village or local communities for their significant contribution in the development of variety which has been registered under the Act. Any person or group or persons or government or non-governmental organization on behalf of any village or local community in India can file in any notified center claim for contribution in the evolution of any new variety. And again, the same protection is granted in the convention countries, means a country which has acceded to an international convention for the protection of plant variety, to which India has also acceded, or a country which has law of protection of plant varieties on the basis of which India has entered into an agreement for granting plant breeders right to the citizen of both the countries. Any person, if a registered plant variety user of this country has been copied by any other conventional country by other without a valid license, then it can be enforced in those convention countries. Under the Act, now they have created a plant up Varieties Protection Appellate Tribunal. As of now, an independent body is not created, but the powers are given to the Intellectual Property Appellate Board, where a technical member has been appointed, especially for the plant varieties. And if any orders of this PVPAT has been passed, it can be challenged in the respective high courts, and in the tribunals, both in both the cases, it has to be decided within 1 year from the date of application. Thank you. I think I took exact 45 minutes. If any questions, I'm open to the questions.
Thank you, Kiran. Thank you for your critical analysis of the law. I think we really enjoyed your personal experience also. Before we get into the questions, I request Madam Bhuvaneshwari or someone to please share the next session slide, please. Yeah, we have next session on the topic of approach towards the advocate on record examination of Supreme Court and its outlook by one of our alumni, Srimati Shrestha, alumni of VCL, and she's also an advocate on record, Supreme Court of India. Thank you, ma'am. Please, I request all the participants to participate in the said webinar and make it a grand success. Yeah, Mr. Kiran.
Yeah. Can
you hear us?
Hello.
Yeah, Kiran. Yeah. Are we audible?
Question.
No, I don't think so. Anybody asked question. No, I'll read out the question from the chat box. I'll just read out the question from the chat box, Kiran. Uday Sanaki asks, Does the protection applicable to only to a specific plant variety, or it extends to all types of crops?
Pardon?
The protection contemplated in the law extends only to plant variety, or it extends to all types of crops?
It extends to all types of crops. It might be either cereals or anything. Okay. That is why I said whatever you can grow, that can be protected. Because the food is never be manufactured. Though we say burger and everything, again, the base is what you grow.
I think you can call recall the PepsiCo company's case on some four farmers. They sued four farmers for 1 crore each for breach of some
in going growing the potatoes.
So if you remember that's a case with regarding to a particular kind of potato which they were growing. See, that one of the variety which PepsiCo used to distribute to the
Correct.
People for growing, that has been used by these farmers. But anyway, the matter was settled because the right intervention of the authority, it was settled. Because it was already at the verge of...
And also PepsiCo was globally criticized for filing that suit.
Yes.
That was also another reason why they settled it.
Because its brand market got affected. The PepsiCo claimed that it want to help the farmers, but the end result, it shows that it is actually benefiting and not passing on the whatever the benefit it got to the farmers. That's why the appellate authority involved in that, and it gave a verdict in favor of the farmers. And moreover, because its brand got affected, it stopped the suit. It withdrew the suit actually, as not pressed.
Yes.
At the same
some
time,
other questions
I
are
think
there.
That case.
Yes, continue.
Yes, sir.
The said case also brought us to the way that the MNC was dealing with the plant varieties and the farmers especially, and the agreements that they were executing. I think they were also using their own pesticides. No?
That's why in the
These
beginning
all,
of the
lecture,
I remember the great man, Professor Nanjan Swami. That is what he expressed when Monsanto came into India. He said, this is what you are... Now we are going back to the traditional knowledge. What we are doing is we are getting the seeds from these companies where they mutated in such a way that it cannot regenerate. First, second, you have to use a particular pesticide again, which is its offshoot companies, and use the chemical fertilizers. In again, organic at the health of it is not actually organic. Even today, I remember my grandfather used to grow. ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಅಡ್ವಾನ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಕ್ ಮೆನ್ಯೂರ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ. ಸೊ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ವೈ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಮಲ್ಟಿ ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಕಂಪನೀಸ್ ದೇ ವಾಂಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲಾಯ್ಟ್ ದಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಎ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಕ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಪೆಪ್ಸಿಕೋ ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ಆನ್ ದ ಪೊಟ್ಯಾಟೋ. So this wanted to be avoided, and hence this variety protection came into picture. And now it has become so health conscious and everything because of all the chemicals. Now we are going back to organic farming. It is nothing but the old wine in the new bottle. What traditionally our forefathers used to grow, that has been given a more scientific advantage, like use of highly mutated variants for many crops and other things.
Thank you, Karan. There's another question. What are the consequences when the protection expires? Does it be registered again?
After Prajakta the renewal, that's, said, that's why I took the example of Pandupura, who makes a special jaggery. He said, I am keeping it as my trade secret. After 15 years, you will sell it and I will lose the customers because that particular jaggery is supplied to most of the I will issue, especially in Kerala, 80% you don't believe it is purchased by it. And for a packet of jaggery, which I made a request, it took 2 weeks to hand over because he had a customer lined up. You have to make some adjustment. Just half a kilo packet. ನಾನು ಹೋಗಿ ಯಾವಾಗಲೂ ಹೇಳ್ತಲ್ಲ ರೆಗ್ಯುಲರ್ ಆಗಿ
ತಗೋಬಂದಿ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಎಸ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಇಯರಿಂಗ್ ಯು ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ರಾಘವೇಂದ್ರ ಶಾಲೆ ಐ ಮೀನ್ ಇಂಟರ್ಫಿಯರ್ ನೌ ಹಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಇಯರಿಂಗ್ ಯು ಹಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಇಯರಿಂಗ್ ಯು ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಒನ್ ಪರ್ಟಿನೆಂಟ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಇಸ್ ರೈಸ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಅನಿಲ್ ಕಾಲ್ಗಿ is that when farmer and their produce is protected, why is that government is extending so much of subsidy to the farmers and indulging in loan waiver?
ಸರ್ ಇದು ಹೇಗೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಕೋಳಿ ಮೊದಲ ಮೊಟ್ಟೆ ಮೊದಲ ಅನ್ನೋ ಕತೆ. ನಾವು ಅಭ್ಯಾಸ ಮಾಡಿಸ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೀವಿ ಸರ್, ಅದು ರಿಸರ್ವೇಶನ್ ಎರಡನ್ನ ಅಭ್ಯಾಸ ಮಾಡಿಸ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿದ್ವಿ, ತಗೊಳಕ್ಕಾಗಲ್ಲ. As simple as it is, if I say it. But it is required, but though I have given a blunt answer, but I can justify farmer subsidy loan anta because we have not created a proper market and proper pricing for the farmer goods. So, neevu ivattu kaaligaka chappli 100 rupay kodtira. ಅದೇ ಏನಾದ್ರು ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಅಕ್ಕಿ 150 ರೂಪಾಯಿ ಆಯ್ತು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಗಲಾಟೆ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರ. ಮನುಷ್ಯ ಎಣ್ಣೆಗೆ ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ 100 ರೂಪಾಯಿ ಕೊಡ್ತಾನೆ, ಅದೇ ಒಂದು ಲೀಟರ್ ಹಾಲಿಗೆ 4 ರೂಪಾಯಿ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಮಾಡಿ ಕಚ್ಚಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಯು ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಇಟ್ ಔಟ್ ಸರ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ದ ಆಕ್ಚುಯಲ್ ಸಫರರ್ಸ್. ಯಾಕೆಂದ್ರೆ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಗ್ಯಾರಂಟಿ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಈಲ್ಡ್, ನೋ ಗ್ಯಾರಂಟಿ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪ್ರೈಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟೋರೇಜ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್. ಯಾಕೆಂದ್ರೆ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ ಪೆರಿಷಬಲ್ ಗೂಡ್ಸ್. We have not dealt, that's what I said, when the scientific research is done. I gave an example in one of the statistics. Real agricultural experience, we all became literates and government bodies is with literates without knowing the knowledge how to protect the farmers' right, are making the policies, are just giving statistics for their bosses so that they will be quiet. At least that is benefiting something, the farmers, at least this loan waivers and everything.
Thank you, Kiran.
One question by Kalpana Madam, I think. Are farmers' rights really being protected? What's the future of our farmer in India? How can the farmers benefited from these laws? A very interesting question. What are the future for farmers in India? I know there is a lot of agitation happening regarding to the farmers and everything. Oh, this will get industrialized, all that. That's why I said, nothing will happen, madam, because farmers are educated. We are literates. We may make any laws or we may make a company as this is a farmer agricultural company. In a way, better they will get if you, okay, you go for a group farming or if you buy a huge land, whom you appoint, not a doctoral fellow who has done his agriculture field, a fellow who knows how to sow. Salt water, latimshaka, denikendra, ಭತ್ತ ಬೆಳಿಬೋದೋ ಇಲ್ಲೋ ಅಂತ, ವೆದರ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಗುಡ್ ಗ್ರೈನ್, ಹೂ ವಿಲ್ ನೋ ದಟ್? ಯು ಮೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡನ್ ಯುವರ್ ರಿಸರ್ಚ್, ಸೈಂಟಿಫಿಕ್ ರಿಸರ್ಚ್, ಆಲ್ ಅದರ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್, ಬಟ್ ಹೂ ವಿಲ್ ಡೂ ದ ರಿಯಲ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್? ಅಟ್ ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ಬೈ ದಟ್ ವೇ ದಿಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಎ ಅಶ್ಯೂರ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ಕಮ್. ನೀವು ಎಂಪ್ಲಾಯಿ ಅಂತ ತಗೊಂಡಾಗ ಇಟ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿಯಲೈಸ್ಡ್, ಅಟ್ ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಅಶ್ಯೂರ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ಎವರಿ ಮಂತ್.
Okay, Raghavendra.
Kiran, what is your opinion on the latest ongoing issues as farmers are agitating the application or implementation of laws and with respect to minimum support price and compulsory registration of seed? What is your big picture that you have in your mind?
A lot of big picture, I don't know, I can share it on a public platform. Moreover, because this my topic was consigned to the act, that all the four acts are not applicable here. But still, I give you a small example.
Thank you, Kiran.
I will give you a small example in a different way. ಯಾರೇ ಒಬ್ಬ ನಿಜವಾದ ರೈತ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅವನಿಗೆ ದುಡ್ಡು ಬೇಕು ಅಂದಾಗ, ಈಗ ಸಾಮಾನ್ಯವಾಗಿ ನಾವು ತೆಂಗು ಬೆಳಿತೀವಿ, ನಮ್ ತಂದೆಗೆ ಏನಾದ್ರು ದುಡ್ಡು ಬೇಕು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ರೆಗ್ಯುಲರ್ ನಾವು ಒಂದು ಮಣ್ಣಿ ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತೀವಿ ಕಾಯಿನ. ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಅವ್ನು ಫೋನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಹೇಳೋ, ಒಂದು 50,000 ಕೊಡು ಅಂತ ಅವ್ನು ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಕಳಿಸ್ತಾನೆ. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಬಂದಾಗ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಹಣ, ನಮ್ದು ಎರಡು ಕಾಯಿ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಗತ್ತೆ ಅಣ್ಣ ಅಂತ ಅವ್ರು 50,000 ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಬಡ್ಡಿ ಲೆಕ್ಕ ಕೊಡ್ತೀವಿ. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ದ ಲೋಕಲ್ ಕಮ್ಯುನಿಟಿ ಈಸ್ ಬೀನ್ ವರ್ಕಿಂಗ್, ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ಸ್ ಕಮ್ಯುನಿಟಿ. ನೀವು ಅದನ್ನ ಹಂಗ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು, ಇಲ್ಲ ನಾನು ಬ್ಯಾಂಕಲ್ಲಿ ಕೊಡ್ತೀನಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕಲ್ಲಿ ಎಷ್ಟು ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಸಾಲ ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂತ ನಮ್ಗೆಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಗೊತ್ತಿದೆ. எனக்கு ஃபோன் மாவட்ட யோசனை கூட தேவை பேங்கிங் அந்த கொடுத்தேன் நான் மோர் பர்டிகுலர்லி அந்த அக்ரிகல்ச்சர் ப்ராடக்ட்ஸ் திஸ் ஆர் சம் டீத்திங் ப்ராப்ளம்ஸ் இஸ் தேர் பட் ஓவர் த டைம் எவ்ரி திங் வில் ஃபால் இன் லைன் ப்ராப்ளம் அதுக்கு ஹெல்த்தா இருந்தது நீவு லா மாட்டீரா பட் அது பேக் கிரவுண்ட் சப்போர்டிங் சிஸ்டம் ரெடி மாடல்ல ಈಗ ರೈತನಿಗೆ ಸಡನ್ ಆಗಿ ಯಾರು ಹುಷಾರಿರಲ್ಲ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಅವನಿಗೆ ಒಂದು ಲಕ್ಷ ದುಡ್ಡು ಬೇಕು ವಿಚ್ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ವಿಲ್ ಪ್ರೊವೈಡ್ ಬೇಸ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ಇಸ್ ಫಾರಂ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಯು ಕಮ್ ಔಟ್ ವಿತ್ ಸಮ್ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಬಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಲಾಂಗ್ ರನ್ ಎಸ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬೆನಿಫಿಟ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ಸ್ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಮಿಡ್ಲ್ ಮ್ಯಾನ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ಎ ಪಿ ಎಂ ಸಿ ಏನಾಗಿದೆ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ಅನ್ ಏಜೆಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಕಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಅದು ಓಪನ್ ಟ್ರೂತ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಒನ್ ನೋಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಕಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ವಾಟ್ ಅಂತ ಕಷ್ಟಪಡೋನ್ ಯಾರೋ ದಲ್ಲಾಳಿ ಯಾರೋ ಬಟ್ ಅವನ ಕಟ್ ಏನಿದೆ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ರಿಯಲಿ ಗ್ರೋಯಿಂಗ್ ವೆರಿ ಹ್ಯೂಜ್ ನಾವೇ ನೋಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ ನಮಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿರೋ ಮಂಡಿಲಿ 10,000 ರೂಪಾಯಿ ಕಾಯಿ ತಗೊಳ್ತಾರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನನ್ನ ಹೆಂಡತಿ ಹೋಗಿ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರು ಮೆಟ್ರೋದಲ್ಲ ಇದ್ರಲ್ಲ ಕಾಯಿ ತಗೊಳ್ತಾರೆ 40 ರೂಪಾಯಿ ನಾನು ಊರಲ್ಲಿ 16 ರೂಪಾಯಿ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಮ್ಮ ಸಿ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಒನ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಮೆನಿ ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ನಾಟ್ ಥಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದೇರ್ ಓನ್ ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟೈಲ್ಸ್ I tell you a small example. One of my friend is a mango grower in Namnagra. Nange ee varshadavargu gottirilla a peculiar mango he is growing anta. Yakare avu yavattu martane irilla ella export martta iddu. Ee pandemic alli export madagilla. Tan mane ond box kodru. Nan alla ishtu varshadinda parichaya ivattu kodtidira anta. Kirana naalu ittkalak aitirilla kanu box ittirilla ee sari export illa adike local marketing bittidini. Neen bartu nodbeku anustala anta. So there are few farmers who have really made efforts to market their products in a very effective manner. So that has to be taken care of. Now see, nan helide tengikai nan yavagalo on sari kaaralu hodaga ooru 1000 tengikai thanbitte arjanan manege 100 rupay kotre 20 rupay kotre 4 rupay nan laabha galva illa nan manege 40 rupay ko kai kotta idini nan yake nam bodka bara bara just imagine. Why can't you? Your own committee. And at the time, we were talking about single button friends. So, I am Kiran. Thought that that was another. We are all becoming so literate. We are all becoming so literate without knowing the real education. Sir, Professor Krishna Gowdar, on another time.
Yes, sir.
Raghavendra, voice break.
Yeah, Kiran, there is another question. There is another question.
So, voice is not there.
What is jurisdictional aspects? This is a question asked by Uday Sanaki. He wants to know jurisdictional aspects for dispute resolution under plant variety law.
Pardon?
We have civil and criminal jurisdiction issues are there. So where exactly the cases have to be filed? What is the jurisdiction?
Clearly defined, CRPC will clearly define. You can file a police complaint, an infringement suit.
Yeah, thank you. I think there is more
the protection applicable to only to a specific plant variety or it extends to all types of crops. It extends to all types of crops, as I said, which falls within the criteria of novelty and other four criteria which I already shared with you. If that four criteria are met, it extends to all type of crops, even including trees. Not only crops, trees. Jackfruit trees, the variants. If I go and look at the registry, I was surprised. This many 1,000 kind of jackfruit idiya anta.
I think this law also provides innocent infringement is also another aspect that this law tries to save the farmers who innocently infringe sometimes. I think this is the only law which provides innocent infringement as a defense. Do you think it's a good initiative to protect especially farmers?
Sir, at the initial it is required, sir, because see, many times it so happens, even to create problem, people will make use of misuse of the farmers. What happened in the PepsiCo case also, same thing. ಏನಂದ್ರೆ ಪಕ್ಕದಲ್ಲಿ ಅಣ್ಣ ನಿನ್ನ ಬೆಳೆ ಇಷ್ಟೊಂದು ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಬಂದೈತೆ, ನನಗೆ ಇನ್ನು ಯಾವ್ದಣ್ಣ ಇದು ಬೀಜ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ತಗೊಂಡ ನಾನೇ ಕೊಡ್ತೀನಿ. ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಹೆಂಗೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿದ್ದೀವಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ನು ಬೇಕಪ್ಪ, ನಾನು ಒಬ್ಬನೇ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿರೋದಲ್ಲ ನೀನು ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿರಪ್ಪ ಅಂತಾರೆ. ಬೇರೆ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಆತರ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿ ಮಾಡಲ್ಲ, ನಾನೊಬ್ಬ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿರ್ಬೇಕು ನೀನೇನಾರು ಅಂತ ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಇನ್ನು ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾತ್ರ ನಾನೊಬ್ಬ ಲಾಭ ಮಾಡೋದಲ್ಲ ನೀನು ಮಾಡ್ಕೊ ಅನ್ನೋದು. ಸೊ ದಟ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್ ಟಿಲ್ ಆಸ್ ಯು ಸೇಡ್ ದಟ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ವೆರಿ ಮಚ್ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಡ್. ಐ ಸೇ ಐ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಸೇ ಎಜುಕೇಟೆಡ್, ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್. ಎಷ್ಟೋ ಸರಿ ಎಷ್ಟೋ ಜನಕ್ಕೆ ಸಬ್ಸಿಡಿ ಇರೋದು ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ. ನಾನು ಹೇಳಿದ್ನಲ್ಲ ವೆಲ್ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಪಾಂಡವಪುರದ ರೈತ, ನನಗೇನೆ ಹೇಳ್ದ ಪಾಠ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇಷ್ಟು ಬರೀ 15 ವರ್ಷ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಊರು ತುಂಬ ಹಂಚ್ಕೊ ಬರ್ತಾರೆ. ಬೇಡ ನನಗೆ ಕಷ್ಟ. ಥಿಂಕ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಐ ಮೇಕ್ ಇಟ್ ಎಸ್ ಎ ಟ್ರೇಡ್ ಸೀಕ್ರೆಟ್, ಕೀಪ್ ಇಟ್ ಎಸ್ ಎ ಟ್ರೇಡ್ ಸೀಕ್ರೆಟ್. ಟ್ರೇಡ್ ಸೀಕ್ರೆಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎವರ್ ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲ, ನಿಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾಕೆ ಹೇಳುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ನಾನು ಅಪ್ಪ ತಪ್ಪಾಯ್ತು ಕಣಪ್ಪ ಕೇಳ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೆ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ವೆನ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ಸ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಡ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ದೇ ನೋ ಹೌ ಟು ಪ್ರೊಟೆಕ್ಟ್ ದೆಮ್ಸೆಲ್ಫ್.
Thank you, Kiran. Thank you for your answers. I think there are some more questions due to positive
trend. Prices as resulted in depletion of groundwater resource. This in turn has led to the acute shortage of water in India. What is the way forward for long-term sustainability efficiency? Sir, let me tell you, I don't know who has written this question. Excessive use of water and inefficient farm practices has resulted. This is a wrong notion, whichever you have. ಸ್ವಾಮಿ, ರೈತ ಬೆಳಿಬೇಕು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಭೂಮಿಗೆ ನೀರು ಉಯ್ಯೋದು, ಬೇರೆ ಎಲ್ಲೂ ಉಯ್ಯಲ್ಲ. ಎಕ್ಸೆಸಿವ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಬೈ ಮೆಟ್ರೋಸ್, ಅರ್ಬನ್ ಏರಿಯಾಸ್, ನಿಮ್ ಕಾರ್ ಕುಡಿಯಕ್ಕೆ, ಇನ್ನೇನೇನ ಕುಡಿಯಕ್ಕೆ, ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರೀಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ದೇ ಪೊಲ್ಯೂಟ್. ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಡಿಪ್ಲೇಷನ್ಗೆ ಕಾರಣಗಳು ಇದು, ನಾಟ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ಸ್. ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬ್ಲೇಮ್. ಯಾಕೆ ನಾನು ಬೆಳೆ ಬೆಳಿಬೇಕು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನೀರಿಗೆ ಮಣ್ಣಿಗೆ ನೀರು ಉಯ್ಯೋದನು, ಬೇರೆ ಎಲ್ಲೂ ಉಯ್ಯಲ್ಲ. ನೀವು ತನ್ನ ಕಾರ್ ಹೋಗ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಡ್ರೈನೇಜಲ್ಲಿ ಬಿಡ್ತೀರಾ.
Thank you, Kiran.
Thank you. Yes, thank you, Kiran. Due to paucity of time, Kiran. Yeah, Kiran. I think we'll stop the question and answer session because time is up.
Sir.
Yes, Professor Bulla, sir.
Yes, Dr. Bulla has a question.
Sir, yes, sir. I have a small question. I have put it in the...
searching for you, Dr. Bulla, sir.
Yeah. Very kind
please,
of you, sir. Please,
go ahead, sir.
You are kindly aware that the potato farmers of PepsiCo company were prosecuted and later on there was some small arrangement. I wish to know from you the protective measures possible for such kind of farmers who were innocent enough of the so-called intellectual property rights that were acquired and usurped by a very big company like PepsiCo.
So that's why I said the authority has intervened in this and it threatened to revoke all the protection given to the plant varieties because the act will not say exploitation is not allowed under the act. Under that ground, I revoke not only this, all the registration granted to the PepsiCo. Then only they withdraw. They bent down and they said, okay, we will withdraw. Because one good thing, as he rightly said, Raghunandan sir asked me, innocent farmers protect money, beko bedo anta, salpa dina beko sir, namo tilkolke baruvaru anta adakke andinna.
That's sir, as you are kindly aware, as I understood, the PepsiCo farmers, they were trying to explore the residue that was left out while they were farming the variety of potato which is used in making the so-called chips and kurkure-like items. And for that also, see, as you had rightly pointed out, the authorities could have been intervened and they could have settled the problem. But per se, the PepsiCo company had acquired that kind of right. And there is at that juncture, I feel, a loophole in the system. And I wish to hear from you as to how to plug that loophole.
If you look at that actual PepsiCo case, it is not actually under Plant Varieties Act. It is under Patent Act because a particular technology used by them to manufacture that seed was patented. It is valid in 2031. So in that guise, they wanted to take advantage. Because of the patent law permits for you, for high infringement and damages, which is at a higher grade, they use that. That's where the authority went in, and it says, though that is only for a process, they have not used that process, they have not done the process or whatever, the technology. They simply use the seed which is being protected under the Act. But fortunately, the seed is not given protection under the Act. That's why they said, we will revoke all that, and we will file for revocation of patent also. And apart from that, in the guise of helping farmers, which they were branding and getting profit, then they say community sharing, we will involve your profit margin also. Because community sharing, compensation, everything will be paid by the authority. So this is some of the negotiation took place between the company and the government authority. And as its brand is getting weaker throughout the world, because the entire farming community in the world is very stronger, they said, you are telling that you are helping farmers. In a way, you wanted to exploit.
That's correct. That's
to safeguard their skin, they withdrew all the suits.
And that's what is happening everywhere, sir. You see, even with respect to BT cotton seeds and other seeds that are sown there in AP or any other area, even in Karnataka, we have the farmers being exploited, and there hasn't been right intervention by the authorities. And the innocent farmers, when they are involved, the state authorities, which as you have rightly pointed out, there should have been that kind of liaison that was made, and the concerned authorities' initiative was very laudable. And all the time, my concern is that all the time it may not be appropriate intervention happening and to protect the farmers' interests. Say, in one form or the other, whether that is Plant Varieties Act or the Patent Act, from the farmer's point of view, what is being done, and what should have been the way of approach by the farmers? Being very poor and being vulnerable, they enter into such kind of agreements, and when they are trying to make use of some residue, that is what the residue seed, even if they are not farming and leaving out the residue would germinate and that grow. And at that juncture, the farmers were being prosecuted and exploited, and that kind of exploitation of the innocents is what is happening. And to plug that loophole, what effective measures do you suggest? That is what I wish to know.
See, if you look at the Act, for example, I being a farmer, purchase a particular breed from a registered breeder. I sow it. That's why the resow power is given to the farmers in this Act. That is where some of raised what is this BT cotton. See, that is why many of the commercial seeds which are marketed today in India, they have mutated in such a way that they should not regenerate.
That's correct.
But the organic farming, the traditional knowledge in the market, it is those seeds where it can regenerate. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಇವತ್ತು ಅದು ದೊಡ್ಡದಾಗಿ ಪ್ರೊಪಗೆಂಡಾ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರು ಎನ್ ಜಿ ಒಗಳಾಗಲಿ ಯಾವ್ದಾರಾಗ್ಲಿ. ಇನ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಟು ಅವಾಯ್ಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕಮರ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲಾಯಿಟೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಬೈ ದ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ಸ್ ಮೊನ್ಸೆಂಟ್ ಅದು ಅಷ್ಟಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ಅಷ್ಟೊಂದು ದೊಡ್ಡ ಗಲಾಟೆ ಆಗಿತ್ತು. ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಯೂಸ್ ಎ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಇನ್ಸೆಕ್ಟ್ ಇದು ಪೆಸ್ಟಿಸೈಡ್ಸ್ ಎ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಮೆನ್ಯು ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ವಿತ್ ದೋಸ್ ಕಂಪನೀಸ್.
ಯೆಸ್.
ಅಂಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ದ ಪ್ರೈಸ್ ದೇ ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ಡ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಪೇ. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ವ್ಯವಸಾಯ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಹೆಂಗಾಗಿದೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಾನು ಸಹಾಯ ನೀನು ಸಹಾಯ ಮನೆ ಮಕ್ಕಳೆಲ್ಲ ಸಹಾಯ ಅಂತಾರೆ.
ಯು ಆರ್ ದಿ ಪರ್ಸನ್ಸ್ ಹೂ ಶುಡ್ ಇನಿಶಿಯೇಟ್ ಟು ಗೋ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರೊಟೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಟು ದಿ ಕನ್ಸರ್ನ್.
ನಮಗೆ ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಮುಗಿಸಿದ ತಕ್ಷಣಗಳೇ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು ಇನಿಶಿಯೇಟಿವ್ ಅಂದ್ರಲ್ಲ ಹಿಂಗೆ ನಮ್ಮ ತಂದೆ ಸ್ನೇಹಿತರು ಕೇಳಿದ್ರು ನಮ್ಮ ತಂದೆ ನಾವು ನಿಮ್ ಮಗ ಹೆಂಗ್ ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಮುಗಿಸ್ತಾ ಅದೇ ನಾನು ನಾಲೆಡ್ಜು ಮತ್ತೆ ಇದು ಕೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಲ್ಲ ವೆದರ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಎಜುಕೇಟೆಡ್ ಆರ್ ಲಿಟ್ರೇಟ್ ಅಂತ ನಮ್ ತಂದೆ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರು ನೀವು ಮಗ ಕೈಗೆ ಬಂದವನ್ನ ಇನ್ನೇನು ವ್ಯವಹಾರ ಎಲ್ಲ ವಹಿಸ್ಬಿಡು ಅಂತ. ಮಗಂಗೆ ಗೌರಿಗೆ ಕೊಟ್ರೆ ಮಡೆ ಗದ್ದೆ ತೆಗೆದು ಮೆದೆ ಹುಟ್ಟಿದಂತೆ ಅಂತಾರೆ ಅಂತ. ಇನಿಷಿಯೇಟಿವ್ ನಾವು ತಗೊಳಕ್ ಅದೇ ಕತೆ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಅದನ್ನ ಯಾರಾದ್ರೂ ದೊಡ್ಡವ್ರು ತಗೋಬೇಕು ಸರ್, ನಿಮ್ಮ ದೊಡ್ಡವ್ರು ತಗೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಲ್ಯಾಬ್ ನೈಸ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ.
Thank you.
Oh, actually, farmers are you know getting helped by a lot of academicians like you, Dr. Mohan Bala.
Sir,
we have to do something.
I'm not directly in a position to go and help the farmers, and Kiran and Raghavendra can do that.
Yes.
And what I think is that all the stakeholders must put in to pave the way for a proper initiative by the government, and there is a need for a proper law which is meant for the protection of the farmers from being exploited by the companies like Monsanto or PepsiCo.
Yes, sir, it has to be properly implemented also.
Yeah, that's it.
Okay, that's it. Right. Thank
very
you.
Kind of
thank
you,
you
for
sir. Thank
for
you.
Giving me an opportunity and answering the
thank you very much, sir. We are really grateful to you.
Yeah.
And we always acknowledge your presence in all our webinars. Thank you so much for your presence, sir.
Kind of
sir, before we conclude the sessions, may I request our principal, Vivekananda College of Law, to render vote of thanks, please, sir.
First of all, let me profusely thank Kiran for his extensive research on the topic and educating us on this burning issue. In fact, the farmers are exploited a lot in the country, and to empower them through this legislation is a ray of hope for the farmers. I think younger generation certainly will turn their attention towards agriculture and to improve the economic condition of the farmers, perhaps. With this hope, I thank Kiran profusely for having accepted our invitation and to educate us on this particular issue. Thank you, Kiran. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. It's a pleasure. Always a pleasure and duty, sir.
Thank you. And also thank and acknowledge the presence of Sri Lakshmi Manohar. Sir, he is the managing committee member of Janata Education Society. Sir, thank you very much for your support. And I also thank Shrimati Bindu S. Mayana, the honorable member of Janata Education Society, for your support, madam. I also acknowledge the presence and thank Professor Sudesh, professor from University Law College, Bangalore, Professor Mohan Rao Balla, principal of Krishnu Jayanti Law College, Bangalore. And I also thank Professor Jaisimha, principal of B.V. Bellad Law College, Belagam. And I take pleasure to thank Savita Patil from Hurkadli Ajja Law College, Dharwad. And I also thank Dr. Ravi and Professor Rupa S. from Vidyavardhaka Law College, Bangalore. And as usual, my friend, Shri Shuprasad, sir, Professor Shuprasad, director of Bangalore Academic of Bangalore Law College, Bangalore. And I thank him profusely. And I thank our own alumna, Dr. Anita K.N., an assistant professor from Government Law College, Ramnagar. And host of other dignitaries have participated in the discussion. And I thank each one of you. I thank the office bearers of Bangalore Bar Association, legal practitioners, other academics, and the student friends and my colleagues profusely for making this program a grand success. And we are going to have some more lectures. We are planning to end our first series by 7th August. We are going to have our alumni like Jeshta. She is a practicing advocate and advocates on the record at Supreme Court. Then one more advocate practicing in Supreme Court, Sister Jessie Kurian, will address us. And then after that, Honorable Justice Shyamprasad sir, Honorable Justice Nagmohan Das, and Honorable Justice Indiresh, and other dignitaries are going to address us. And our own alumni and a serious practitioner, and our organizing secretary, Srimati Pratima Vannapuri, is also going to address us in one of the sessions. These are all the plan we have. I seek same cooperation from you all for in all our future endeavor. With this, I thank